Hildana, your word is falsetto. Falsetto.
Can I have the definition?
Okay. Definition of falsetto is an artificially high voice. And using it in a sentence, Dad draped a mop over his head and sang, Mary had a little lamb in falsetto.
Language
of origin is Italian. It came originally from the Latin. Falsetto.
Falsetto. F A L S E T T O. Falsetto.
Your word, daffodil. Daffodil.
Daffodil. D-A-F-F-I-D-I-L. Daffodil.
Okay, Skylar, would you please spell sarcasm? Sarcasm.
Sarcasm. S-A-R-C-A-S-M. Sarcasm.
Okay, Pavani, your word, linden. Linden.
Linden. Can I have the language of origin?
Yeah, the language of origin is originally English.
Can I have a definition?
And the definition? Linden, a tall forest tree of eastern and central North America. The flowers of the linden are noted for their sweet fragrance. Linden.
Linden. L-I-N-D-E-N. Linden.
Okay, Eddie, your word is a homonym. The word is canasta. And canasta is a card game that is a form of rummy usually played in a two-hand or four-hand partnership. In a sentence, on Sunday afternoons, the family got together to play canasta. Canasta.
Canasta. C-A-N-A-S-T-A.
Okay, Mark, your word. Belladonna. Belladonna.
Belladonna. Can I have the language of origin?
Belladonna is from the Italian.
Belladonna. B-E-L-L-A-D-O-N-N-A. Belladonna.
Gabrielle, your word is imperative. Imperative.
Imperative. May I have a definition?
Yes. Imperative means not to be avoided or evaded. Urgent. Compulsory. For Nell to be able to go to the prom, it was imperative that she pass her history test. Imperative.
Imperative. I M P E R A T I V E. Imperative.
Jesse, your word, croquet, croquet.
Okay. C-R-O-C-H-E.
Okay, Seth, would you please spell refugee?
Refugee.
Refugee.
R-E-F-U-G-E. Refugee.
Lewis, your word is panzer. Panzer.
Panzer. May I have the definition, please?
The definition of panzer is a vehicle belonging to a mechanized unit of the German army in World War II, organized for rapid attack. A Canadian War Museum, using this in a sentence, a Canadian War Museum spent 2 years restoring a World War II Panzer.
Panzer. P-A-N-Z-E-R. Panzer.
Lieutenant, your word. Cognition. Cognition.
Cognition. C-O-G-N-I-T-I-O-N.
Your word. Gordita. Gordita.
G-O-R-D-E-T-I.
Christian, your word. Biblical. Biblical.
Biblical. May I have the definition, please?
Yes, the definition of biblical means of, relating to, derived from, or in accord with the Bible. The frescoes in the church depicted biblical events. Biblical.
Biblical. B-I-B-L-I-C-A-L. Biblical.
Yeah, your word. Potash. Potash.
Potash. Definition, please.
Potash is potassium carbonate, especially that obtained in colored impure form by leaching wood ashes. In a sentence, in colonial days, potash was used to make soap.
Are there any alternate
pronunciations? It is either potash or potash.
Can you repeat the word?
Potash.
Potash. P-O-T-A-S-H. Potash.
Okay, John, your word. Lithe.
Lithe. Now the definition, please.
Yes, lithe means agile and easily flexed. Supple. Angela enjoyed watching the lithe basketball players in action. Lithe.
Lithe. L I T H E. Lithe.
Your word is Odori. Odori.
Odori. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
Can I have a language of origin, please?
The language of origin is Japanese.
Japanese. Odori. O-T-O-R-I. Odori.
And Ashley, would you please spell the word credible? Credible.
Credible?
Credible.
Credible. C-R-E-D-I-B-L-E. Credible.
Okay, Sophie, you have a homonym. The word is hawthorn, and in a sentence, in a definition, the hawthorn is a spring-flowering shrub or tree with thorny branches. In a sentence, many small birds took up residence in the large hawthorn. Hawthorn.
Hawthorn. H-A-W-D-H-O-R-N. Hawthorn.
AJ, your word, fiasco. Fiasco.
Fiasco. May I have language of origin?
Language of origin, it is from a Germanic element that went into Italian before entering English.
May I have a definition?
The definition of fiasco is an utter and often ridiculous failure, especially of an ambitious undertaking. The auto company's fiasco is in equipping its cars with defective tires led to a public outcry. Fiasco.
Fiasco. F-I-A-S-C-O. Fiasco.
Okay, your words are great. Chipotle. Chipotle.
Chipotle.
Use
the sentence.
And in a sentence, I'll define it and use it in a sentence. Chipotle is a smoked and usually dried jalapeno. Bonita spiced her stew with a chopped chipotle.
Chipotle.
C-H-I-P-O-T-L-E.
Yeah. Your word is wanderlust. Wanderlust.
Wanderlust. May I have the definition?
Wanderlust is a strong or unconquerable longing or impulse toward traveling or going about idly for pleasure and relaxation. Wanderlust in a sentence. Kate's wanderlust caused her to postpone college so that she could tour Europe. Wanderlust.
Wanderlust. W-A-N-D-E-R-L-U-S-T. Wanderlust.
Micah, your word. Mirage.
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 Mirage. M-I-R-A-G-E. Mirage.
Okay, Laura, you have a homonym. The word is iguana. An iguana is any of a large number of herbivorous, chiefly tropical American lizards. In a sentence, Chad built an outdoor cage to house his 3-foot-long pet iguana.
Iguana. I-G-U-A-N-A. Iguana.
Barrett, your word. Sierra. Sierra.
Sierra. S-I-E-R-R-A. Sierra.
Aaron, your word is a homonym. Innate. Innate. Innate means existing in or belonging to some person or other living organism from birth. Kimberly was grateful for her innate sense of direction when she got lost. Innate.
Can I have the origin, please?
Language of origin is Latin.
Innate. I-N-N-A-T-E. Innate.
Okay, Caitlin, your word. Fandango. Fandango.
Fandango. Can I have a definition, please?
Fandango is a lively Spanish dance usually performed by a man and woman with castanets in triple time. Craig and Ursula danced a fandango in the high school talent competition. Fandango.
Fandango. F-A-N-D-A-N-G-O. Fandango.
Bentley, your word. Credentials. Credentials.
Credentials. C-R-E-D-E-N-T-I-A-L-S. Credentials.
Look. Spherical. Spherical.
Spherical. S-P-H-E-R. A-C-L-E.
Okay, Caroline. Alligator. Alligator.
Alligator. A-L-L-I-G-A-T-O-R.
Rachel, your word is vibrato. Vibrato.
Vibrato.
V-I-B-R-A-T-O. Vibrato.
Your word, geoponics. Geoponics.
Geoponics. G-I-L. P-O-N-I-C-S, geoponics.
Okay, Gabriel, your word is a homonym. The word is salami. Salami. And salami is a highly seasoned sausage made of pork and beef. Randy made a sandwich of salami and cheese.
Salami.
Please spell salami.
Salami. S-A-L-A-N-I-A.
Your word, luau, luau.
Can I get a definition?
Yes, luau is a feast with Hawaiian food and usually Hawaiian entertainment. Sabrina wore a grass skirt to the luau. Luau. Tell your word, hosta, hosta.
Is there any alternate to
it's either hosta or hosta?
Hosta, H-O-S-T-A, hosta.
Your word. Tamale. Tamale.
Tamale. Could I have a language of origin?
Yeah. Tamale, the language of in the language of origin, this word went from Nahuatl to Spanish.
Tamale. T-A-M-A-L-E. Tamale.
Ryan, would you please spell diagnosis? Diagnosis.
Could you please repeat the word?
Diagnosis.
Diagnosis. D-I-A-G-N-O-S-I-S. Diagnosis.
And again, your word is petunia. Petunia.
Petunia.
Valerie, would you please spell bequeath?
Definition, please.
Yes, bequeath means to give by formal declaration so that the thing given passes into the ownership of the recipient after the death of the donor. In a sentence, Fred indicated that he would bequeath his car to his oldest son. Bequeath.
Bequeath. B-E-Q-U-E-E-F.
Your word, Shannon. Alfalfa. Alfalfa.
Alfalfa. A-L-F-A-L-F-A. Alfalfa.
Julian, your word, sombrero, sombrero.
Sombrero, S-O-M-B-R-E-R-O, sombrero.
And Anne, would you please spell animosity for us? Animosity.
Animosity. Can I have a language of origin?
Animosity comes from Latin. Animosity.
Animosity. A N I M O S I T Y. Animosity.
Sophia, your word is plateau. Plateau. Yes, a plateau is a usually extensive land area having a relatively level surface raised sharply above adjacent land on at least one side. The Columbia Lava Plateau is situated in eastern Washington and Oregon. Plateau.
Plateau.
P-L-A-T-E-A-U.
Plateau.
Are you finished?
Yes.
Guys, would you please spell strudel? Strudel.
Strudel. Strudel.
Minnie, your word is boutique. Boutique.
Boutique. B-O-U-T-I-Q-U-E. Boutique.
Your word, cantata. Cantata.
Cantata. C-O-N-T-A-T-A.
Nash, would you please spell gristle?
Gristle.
Gristle.
G-R-I-S-T-L-E. Gristle.
Harrison, your word, chronic. Chronic.
Chronic. C-H-R-O-N-I-C. Chronic.
Your word. Green gauge.
May
I? Yeah, green gauge is any of several rather small, rounded, or green, greenish yellow cultivated plums of European origin. For dinner, Charlene had sliced green gauge in syrup. Green gauge.
Green gauge. G R E E N G A G-E, green gauge.
Okay, your word, Emily. Feldspar. Feldspar.
Feldspar. F-E-L-D-S-P-A-R. Feldspar.
Ethan? Giraffe.
Giraffe. G-I-R-A-F-F-E.
Spell the word Olympia.
Olympian. Can I get the definition, please?
Yes, you may. Olympian means a being of lofty detachment or superior attainments. And using it in a sentence, standing beside the Olympian was a less conspicuous achiever who was glad for his modest honors. Olympia.
Language of origin.
is from the Greek, from a Greek geographical name, Olympia.
Olympian. O L. Y.
Skylar, your word is catkin. Catkin.
May I have the language of origin?
Catkin is a word that comes to us from the Dutch. Catkin.
May I have the definition?
The definition of catkin is a spiked inflorescence bearing scaly bracts and eight-petalous unisexual flowers. In a sentence, the catkin, Grace cut from the willow bush, stained her fingers yellow with pollen. Catkin.
Catkin. C-A-T-K-I-N. Catkin.
Enchilada.
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 Can you put it in a sentence?
Yes, putting it in a sentence. An enchilada is a tortilla topped or rolled up with highly seasoned meat or other filling and served with tomato sauce. In a sentence, the sampler platter included a taco, an enchilada, and a burrito. Enchilada.
Enchilada. Can I have a language of origin?
Language of origin is Spanish.
Enchilada. E-N-C-H-I-L-A-D-A. Enchilada.
And Eddie, would you please spell oolong?
Oolong.
Oolong.
Definition, please.
Oolong is a tea that is partially fermented before drying and combines the characteristic of black and green teas. In a sentence, the aroma of the freshly brewed oolong rose from the tiny teacups. Oolong.
Oolong. O-O-L-O-N-G.
Mark, your word is amnesia. Amnesia.
May I have the language of origin?
Language of origin of amnesia is Greek.
Amnesia. A-M-N-E-S-I. Amnesia.
Okay, Gabrielle, your word. Ravioli. Ravioli.
Ravioli. R-A-V-O-L-I. Ravioli.
Okay, your word, Lewis, is vogue.
Vogue. May I have the language of origin?
Language of origin, this is an Italian-derived French word, vogue.
Vogue. And may I have the definition?
Vogue is popular acceptance or favor or popularity. In a sentence, Mila refuses to follow the current vogue of text messaging. Vogue.
Vogue. V-O-G-U-E. Vogue.
Okay, your word is a homonym. The word is rotunda. Rotunda is a round building, especially one that is round both outside and inside and covered by a dome. In a sentence, the carousel is located in a large rotunda.
Rotunda, yes. R-O-T-U-N-D-A.
Okay, Christian, would you spell the word trajectory? Trajectory.
Can we use it in a sentence, please?
I will use it in a sentence. A trajectory is a curve that a body such as a planet or comet in its orbit describes in space. Jennifer computed the satellite's trajectory using the formula for a parabolic orbit. Trajectory.
Can you give me the origin?
Language of origin is Latin.
Trajectory. T-R-E. J-E-C-T-O-R-Y.
Leah, you have a near homonym. Your word is virtuosa. And a virtuosa is a woman who excels in the technique of an art, especially one who is a musical performer. And in a sentence, the virtuosa played the piano concerto with great agility. Virtuosa.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Virtuosa or virtuosa?
Language of origin.
Language of origin is Italian. Virtuosa.
Can you repeat the word?
Virtuosa.
V-I-R-T-U-O-S-A. Virtuosa.
John Dave, your word, mongrel.
Mongrel, can I have the definition, please?
Mongrel is an animal or plant resulting from the interbreeding of two or more breeds. Jeff's dog, using it in a sentence, Jeff's dog is a friendly mongrel named Mutt. Mongrel.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Mongrel or mongrel?
Mongrel. M-O-N-G-R-E-L. Mongrel.
Ashley, would you please spell asterisk? Asterisk.
A-S-T-E-R-I-S-K, asterisk.
Hey, Sophie, your word, sequin, sequin.
Sequin, may I have the definition?
Sequin is a small ornament, flat disc or star or other shape, usually of shiny metal, pierced with a hole for sewing onto cloth in decorative designs. Using it in a sentence, Kayla sewed a bead on top of each sequin to keep it in place. Sequin.
Sequin. S-E-Q-U-I-N. Sequin.
Okay, AJ, your word is a homonym, and the word is cherry. Chari. And using it in a definition, Cherry is hesitant and vigilant about dangers and risk, unwilling to proceed without much consideration. In a sentence, the Cherry investor put his money into mutual funds instead of investing it directly into stocks. Cherry.
You have language of origin.
Language of origin is English.
Charry. C H A R Y. Charry.
Zachary, you have a near homonym also. Your word is muslin. Muslin. It's a plain woven cotton fabric that is used bleached or unbleached for sheeting, embroidery, or other purposes. The simple look of tab curtains made of unbleached muslin is perfect for Barbara's den. Muslin.
Language of origin.
Language of origin. It is from an Iraqi geographical name that went into Arabic, then Italian, then French.
Muslin. M-U-S-L-I-N.
Your word, thesaurus. Thesaurus.
Thesaurus. May I have the definition?
Yeah. Thesaurus is a book containing a store of words or information about a particular field or set of concepts, specifically a dictionary of synonyms. Caleb's paper read as if he had consulted a thesaurus frequently while writing it. Thesaurus.
Thesaurus. T H E S. A U R U S, thesaurus.
Micah, your word. Ridiculous.
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 Ridiculous. R I D I C U L O U S, ridiculous.
And Laura, would you please spell omnipotent? Omnipotent.
Omnipotent. O-M-N-I-P-O-T-E-N-T. Omnipotent.
Mary, your word is junko. Junko.
Can I have the language of origin?
Junko is a word originally from Spanish that passed into Latin.
J-U-N-C-O, jump.
Your word is Boswell.
Can I have the definition, please?
Boswell is one who, out of admiration or hero worship, records in detail, and usually contemporaneously, the life, conversation, and intimate moods of a famous contemporary. The music's, in a sentence, the music's critic, music critic's readers accused him of becoming a mere Boswell to a famous rock star. Boswell.
May I have the origin, please?
The word is from a Scottish name.
Boswell. B-O-S-W-E-L-L. Boswell.
Your word, Caitlin, is Satori. Excuse me. Satori.
Satori. Can I have a definition?
Yes. Satori is a sudden enlightenment and state of consciousness attained by intuitive illumination, representing the spiritual goal of Zen Buddhism. In a sentence, the primary method of achieving Satori is through the use of riddles that provide material for meditation. Satori.
Is there any alternate pronunciation?
There is no alternate pronunciation. Satori.
Satori. S-A-T-O-R-Y. Satori.
Okay, Barrett, your word. Vulcanize. Vulcanize.
Vulcanize. V-U-L-C-A-N-I-Z-E. Vulcanize.
Caroline, your word is Illuminati. Illuminati. Illuminati are persons who are or claim to be unusually enlightened. The mayoral candidate worked hard to win the support of the city's Illuminati.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is from, came from Italian, originally formed from a Latin word. Illuminati.
Illuminati. I-L-L-U-M-I-N-I-T-Y.
Rachel, your word, buccaneer, buccaneer.
Buccaneer, B-U-C-K-I-N-E-E-R.
Okay, Montel, your word is a homonym. The word is pistachio, pistachio. And a pistachio is an edible green seed of a small tree from southern Europe and Asia Minor. In a sentence, Patricia placed a pistachio on each parfait. Pistachio.
Pistachio. P-I-S-T-A-C-H-I-O. Pistachio.
Your word is also a homonym. The word is Homburg. Now, Homburg is a man's hat of smooth finished felt with a stiff, curled, ribbon-bound brim and a high tapered crown creased lengthwise. In a sentence, the villain in the movie wore a dark suit and a black Homburg. Homburg.
Homburg. H O M B U R G.
Your word is relevant.
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 R E L E V E V A N T. Relevant.
Your word. Okay, your word. Hygiene. Hygiene.
Hygiene. H-Y-G-I-E-N-E. Hygiene.
Shanna, your word. Scenario. Scenario.
Can you give me a language of origin?
Language of origin, scenario, it is originally a Greek word that passed into Latin. Scenario.
Scenario. S-C-E-N-A-R-O. Scenario.
Okay, your word, Julia. Benevolent. Benevolent.
Benevolent. B-E-N-E-V-O-L-E-N-T. Benevolent.
And I'd like you to spell cacao.
Cacao. Can I have the definition?
Cacao is a tree native to South America and now extensively cultivated that bears fleshy pods containing numerous seeds. It's used in the preparation of cocoa, chocolate, and cocoa butter. New disease-resistant varieties of cacao are being developed to increase productivity. Cacao.
I have a language of origin.
Language of origin is a word that went from Nahuatl to Spanish. Cacao.
C-A-C-A-O.
Cacao. So your word is impasse. Impasse.
Can I have a definition?
Definition of impasse is a road or way that is blocked or incapable of being traveled or crossed. In a sentence, a rock slide created an impasse on the mountain road. Impasse.
Can you read that?
The word is impasse.
Impasse. I. M-P-A-S-S, impasse.
Okay, please, your word is a homonym. The word is kasha. And kasha is a mush made from coarse cracked buckwheat, barley, or millet. For supper, Boris's mother served stuffed cabbage, kasha, wild mushrooms, and ground pork. Kasha.
K-A-S-H-A, kasha.
Okay, Vinny, your word. Incredulous. Incredulous.
Incredulous. I N C R E D U L O U S. Incredulous.
Nash, would you please spell arsenal?
Arsenal.
Arsenal.
A R S E N A L.
Your word is rhinoceros. Rhinoceros.
Rhinoceros. R-H-I-N-E-R-C-E-R-O-U-S. Rhinoceros.
Would you please spell umlaut? Umlaut.
May I have the language of origin?
Umlaut is originally from German. Umlaut.
May I have it in a sentence, please?
In a sentence, an umlaut is a diacritical mark composed of two adjacent dots placed especially over a German vowel to indicate a change in pronunciation. Gary did not know how to pronounce words with an umlaut until he studied German.
Umlaut. U-M-L-A-U-T. Umlaut.
Emily, would you please spell hydraulic? Hydraulic.
Hydraulic. H Y D R A U L I C. Hydraulic.
Ethan, your word is bratwurst. Bratwurst.
Bratwurst.
B-R-A-T-W-U-R-S-T. Bratwurst.
We will be starting the third round of spelling. After this round, we will have one round of vocabulary and then come back to spelling again.
All right, let's start round three.
Your word is flamenco. Flamenco.
Definition, please.
Pardon me. This word has a homonym. It is a homonym, so I will give you the definition. But flamenco is a vigorous rhythmic dance of the Andalusian gypsies. The dancer entertained the patrons at the Spanish restaurant with a rousing flamenco. Flamenco.
Language of origin, please.
Language of origin. It's originally a Dutch word that passed into Spanish. Flamenco.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
Flamenco. F. L A M E N C O.
Ms. Skyler, would you please spell teriyaki? Teriyaki.
Teriyaki. T E R R I A K H I.
Dominate your word, patriarch. Patriarch.
Patriarch. Can I have a definition?
A patriarch is a man regarded as a father or founder, as of a race or science or religion or class of people. In many religious circles, Adam is considered to be the patriarch of the human race. Patriarch.
Patriarch. Can I have a language of origin?
Language of origin is Greek.
Patriarch. P-A-T-R-I-A-R-C-H. Patriarch.
Okay, Eddie, your word is knish.
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 K-N-I-S-H.
Would you please spell the word omnivorous? Omnivorous.
Is there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations to omnivorous.
Can you please give me the definition?
Yes. Omnivorous means eating everything, especially feeding on both animal and vegetable substances. By observing turtles' eating habits, we learned that they are omnivorous.
Omnivorous. O-M-N-I-V-E-R-O-U-S. Omnivorous.
Hey, Louis, Mahatma. Mahatma.
Mahatma. Language of origin, please.
Language of origin is Sanskrit.
Sanskrit. May I have a definition also?
Definition of Mahatma is a person held worthy of reverence for high-mindedness, wisdom, or selflessness. Daniel trekked for 3 days to seek the advice of the Mahatma.
Mahatma. Okay, I'm going to start off. M-A-H-A-T-M-A.
Tanner, your word is gulag. Gulag.
Can you use it in a sentence, please?
Yeah. Gulag is the penal system of the former Soviet Union, consisting of a network of forced labor camps. Stalin chose a 15th century monastery as the site for the first labor camp of the gulag.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are none.
Gulag. G-O-O-L-A-U-G.
Your word is mascara.
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 Mascara. Definition, please.
Definition of mascara is a cosmetic for covering the eyelashes or eyebrows. Peggy says that her main reason for using mascara is to make her eyelashes appear longer. Your word is mascara.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is Italian.
Any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
Can you repeat the word?
The word is mascara.
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 M-A-S-C-A-R-A. Mascara.
Okay, John, your word is incriminate.
Incriminate, and I'm the definition, please.
Yes, incriminate means to furnish evidence or proof of circumstances showing guilt.
May I use it in a sentence, please?
In a sentence, worried that the defendant's statement would incriminate him, the defense attorney begged him to plead the Fifth Amendment. Incriminate.
May I have the language of origin?
Language of origin is Latin.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
Incriminate. I N C R I M. I-N-A-T-E.
Actually, your word, chimichanga. Chimichanga.
Chimichanga. C-H-I-M-I-C-H-A-N-G-A. Chimichanga.
Your word, Sophie, is Klompen. Klompen.
I have the language of origin.
Language of origin is Dutch. Klompen.
Klompen. K-L-O-M-P-E-N. Klompen.
AJ, would you please spell amenable? Amenable.
Amenable. May I have a definition?
Amenable means readily brought to submit or yield, responsive, tractable. Horst is amenable to nearly any idea for the poem's theme.
May I have language of origin?
Language of origin, it came from French, which formed it from a Latin word.
Amenable. A M E N A B L E.
Your words are babushka. Babushka. A babushka is a usually triangular or triangularly folded kerchief worn over the head and usually tied under the chin. The old woman never went outside without putting on her Babushka.
Language of origin.
Language of origin is Russian. Babushka.
Babushka. B A B U S H K A. Babushka.
Jackson, your word, salve.
Salve, may I have the definition?
Salve is a healing ointment.
Salve. S A L V E. Salve.
Okay, Micah, your word. Regime.
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 R-E-G-I-M-E. Regime.
Your word is a homonym. And the word is boysenberry. And a boysenberry is a very large bramble fruit with a flavor like raspberry. Mark enjoys the tart flavor of a freshly picked boysenberry.
Boysenberry. B-O-Y-S-E-N-B-E-R-R-Y. Boysenberry.
All right, would you please spell duenna? Duenna.
Can I have a language word?
Duenna is a word that went from Latin to Spanish. Duenna.
Duenna. D-U-E-N-N-A. Duenna.
And would you please spell perfidy? Perfidy.
Can I have the definition, please?
Perfidy means the act or instance of deception or betrayal. Kate valued her friendship with Carol too much to let one perfidy destroy it. Perfidy.
Can I have the origin, please?
The language of origin is Latin.
Could you please repeat the word?
Perfidy.
Perfidy. P-E-R-F-I-D-Y. Perfidy.
Evidently, your word is sevruga. Sevruga.
Sevruga. S-E-V-R-U-G-A. Sevruga.
Okay, Montel, you've got another homonym. Your word is ghoul. Ghoul is a legendary evil being held to rob graves and feed on corpses. The poster for the horror movie depicted a ghoul wielding a chainsaw. Ghoul.
Ghoul. G-H-O-U-L. Ghoul.
Okay, John, your word. Mariachi. Mariachi.
Command language of origin.
Language of origin is probably a French-derived Spanish word. Mariachi.
May I have the definition?
Definition is a group of Mexican folk musicians, usually consisting of singers, guitarists, and a violinist. On weekends, using this in a sentence, on weekends, the mariachi entertain diners at the Mexican restaurant. Mariachi.
Mariachi. M. A. R I O C H I. Mariachi.
Your word. Accommodate.
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 Language of origin. The word comes from Latin. Accommodate.
Accommodate. A C C O M A D A T E. Accommodate.
Julia, your word is oratorio. Oratorio.
Oratorio. O R.
please spell epiphany.
Epiphany. Can I have a language of origin?
Language of origin is Greek. Epiphany.
Can I have a definition?
The definition, an epiphany, is a usually sudden manifestation or perception of the essential nature or meaning of something. The short stories of James Joyce often contain the moment of epiphany.
Epiphany. E P I P H A N Y. Epiphany.
Okay, Blaise, your word is a homonym. The word is oleo. And this oleo means a miscellaneous collection as of literary or musical selections. Jason's CD collection is an oleo that rivals that of the local radio station.
O-L-I-O, oleo.
Vinny, your word, precipice. Precipice.
Precipice. P R E C I P I C E. Precipice.
Okay, Nash, you have a homonym. Your word is wanton. Wanton. And it means marked by or manifesting heedless disregard of justice or the right safety and feelings of others. In a sentence, the prosecutor maintained that the victim was attacked with wanton cruelty. Wanton.
Wanton. W-A-N-T-O-N. Wanton.
Please spell bureaucracy. Bureaucracy. Bureaucracy.
May I have the language of origin, please?
The language of origin, it is a French word plus a Greek-derived element. Bureaucracy.
May I have the definition, please?
Bureaucracy is a particular group of government officials. In a sentence, Benton quickly moved up in the bureaucracy of the Justice Department. Bureaucracy.
Bureaucracy. B-U-R-E. A-U-C-R-A-C-Y, bureaucracy.
Okay, Emily, your word, scampi. Scampi.
Can I get a definition?
Scampi is a usually large shrimp. Joel's mouth started watering as he dipped a scampi in the garlic-flavored butter sauce.
Scampi. S-C-A-M-P-I. Scampi.
Okay, Ethan, I'd like you to spell poinsettia.
Poinsettia. P-O-I-N-S-E-T-T-I-A. Poinsettia.
Now, our next round will be a vocabulary round. And what I'm going to do is to provide a word and two alternative potential meanings. You can either restate the potential meaning, or you can say A or B. There will be choices A and B.
All right, let's begin round four.
Okay, Hildana. Your word is opera. Opera. And the question is, where would you look to see an opera? A, at NASA, N-A-S-A, or B, in a theater or house?
B, in a theater or house.
That is either one or both of the responses. Your word is the being a small feat?
A.
Now, Addie, would you please tell me about stethoscope? What is a stethoscope used for? A, seeing something far away, or B, listening to a person's breathing?
B, listening to a person's breathing.
Lewis? Lunatic. What is a lunatic? A, a person who is wildly eccentric, or B, a lighting device?
A.
Okay, Liam. Bangle. Bangle is a type of A, bracelet, B, dance.
A, bracelet.
John David, prescription. Who would give a prescription? A magazine publisher, or B, a doctor?
B.
Ashley, your word is decoy. When would it be helpful to use a decoy? A, when driving, B, when hunting?
B.
And what does it mean, Sophie, to receive a massage? Massage. A, to have urgent information given, or B, to have muscles rubbed or kneaded?
B.
Okay, AJ, your word is polygon, and your choices are A, closed figure consisting of straight lines joined end to end, or B, a representation of different sounds by the same letter.
Can you repeat the word?
Yes, the word is polygon. Polygon. And your choices are a closed figure consisting of straight lines joined end to end, or a representation of different sounds by the same letter.
A.
That's good. Zachary, dissect. To dissect is A, to cut into separate pieces, or B, to manage or guide by advice. Dissect.
A.
Your word is elite. What does it mean to be elite? A, to be short and thin. B, to be better than others. Elite.
B, to be better than others.
Your word, android. Android, what is an android? A, an automaton of human form. Or B, a geometric shape with four cusps.
A.
Laura, your word is muskrat. A muskrat is a type of A, gun, B, rodent.
B.
Diorama. What is a diorama? A scene, scenic representation with lifelike details, or B, a chorus of alto singers. Diorama.
A.
Fiesta. A fiesta is A, midday nap. B, a festival.
B, a festival.
Bentley, the word, what is a discipline? A branch of learning, or B, a correction? Discipline.
A.
Montel, your word is thermal. Thermal. If something is thermal, is it A, relating to or caused by heat? Or B, able to freeze liquid. Thermal.
A.
Your word, waywiser. Single word, waywiser. When would it be appropriate to use a waywiser? A, when walking. B, when eating. Waywiser.
B, you've been eating.
negotiate a treaty.
B, negotiate a treaty.
Place your word holster. When would it be appropriate to use a holster? When wearing pants, A, when wearing pants that are too large, or B, when carrying a gun?
B.
Convenient, your word, adios. Adios is used to express A, congratulations, B, farewell.
B.
And your word, Nash, buck wagon, buck wagon. When would someone use a buck wagon? A, when cutting wheat. B, when hauling a load.
B.
Your word is Soviet. If something is described as Soviet, is it A, associated with the now dissolved USSR, or B, gray or wearing gray?
A, associated with the USSR.
Your word, tycoon. What is a tycoon? A, a businessman of exceptional success, or B, a traditional Japanese inn. Tycoon.
A. A.
Ethan, your word is hustle. What does it mean to hustle? A, to move quickly, or B, to fret anxiously?
A.
Now we will go back to spelling. Your word is neologism. Neologism.
Can I have the definition?
The definition of neologism is a new word. A new word, usage, or expression. Nelson encountered a neologism in almost every paragraph of an article about computers. Neologism.
Language
of origin. This was originally from a Greek word that passed into French before becoming English. Neologism. There are no alternate pronunciations. Neologism.
Neologism. NEOLOGISM.
Your word is picaresque.
Can I have a language of origin?
The language of origin is Spanish.
Can you put it in a sentence?
And I'm putting it in this sentence, defining it and putting it in a sentence. Picaresque means relating to a type of prose fiction in which the principal character is a rogue. In a sentence, in a typical picaresque novel, the hero has many adventures. Picaresque.
Picaresque. PICARESQUE. Picaresque.
Okay, your word, Eddie, is camouflage. Camouflage.
Camouflage. C A M O U F L A G E.
Lewis, would you please spell synchronous? Synchronous.
Synchronous.
Yes.
May I have the definition, please?
Synchronous means recurring or operating at exactly the same periods, mark marked by strict and exact coincidence in time, rate, or rhythm. Suzette noticed that the ticking of the grandfather clock was synchronous with her pulse. Synchronous.
Synchronous. S-Y-N-C-H-R-O-N-O-U-S.
Okay, Leah, your word is peloton.
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 Definition, please.
Peloton is the main body of riders in a bicycle race. The peloton advances slowly at first, picking up speed as darkness approached. Peloton.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is French.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Peloton.
Can you repeat the word?
Peloton.
Peloton. P-E-L-O-T-O-N. Peloton.
John David, you have a homonym. Inselberg. An Inselberg is an isolated mountain, partially buried by the debris and derived from and overlapping its slopes. The bare, rounded Inselberg of rock stands like an island in a sea of vegetation. And I am to ensure that the speller understands that this word is singular. Inselberg.
May I have a language of origin?
The language of origin is German.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Inselberg or Inselberg?
Inselberg. I N S E L B E R G. Inselberg.
Ashley, your word is angstrom. Angstrom.
Angstrom. A-N-G-S-T-R-O-M. Angstrom.
Sophie? Precocious. Precocious.
May I have the language of origin?
Language of origin of precocious is Latin.
Precocious. P-R-E. C-O-C-I-O-U-S, precocious.
Your word is Bowery. Bowery.
Bowery. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
May I have a definition?
Definition of Bowery is a city street or district notorious for cheap saloons and homeless derelicts. The mayor promised to get rid of the fleabag hotels in the Bowery.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is Dutch.
Bowery.
Bowery.
B-O-W-E-R-Y. Bowery.
Your word, Zachary, is allegro. Allegro.
Can you use an instance?
Yes. Allegro is, or means, in a brisk, lively manner, used as a direction in music. The shifting emotions in the music were appropriately expressed allegro, then andante. Allegro.
Allegro. A-L-L-E-G-R-O. Allegro.
Jackson, your word. Kohlrabi. Kohlrabi.
Kohlrabi.
Yes.
May I have the definition?
Kohlrabi is any of a variety of cabbages having an edible stem that become greatly enlarged, fresh, fleshy, and turnip-shaped. The flesh of the kohlrabi resembles that of the turnip, but is sweeter and milder. Kohlrabi.
Kohlrabi. K-O-H-L-R-A-B-I. Kohlrabi.
Your word is metaphor.
Metaphor. M-E-T-A-P-H-O-R. Metaphor.
Okay. Your word, aggregate. aggregate.
Can I have the definition?
An aggregate means the mass or body of units or parts somewhat loosely associated with each other. The protesters straggled toward the muddy park in a dispirited aggregate as the organizers set up tents and microphones. Aggregate.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Aggregate.
Aggregate. E-G-R-E-G-I-A-T-E. Aggregate.
Your word is wampum. Wampum.
Language of origin.
Language of origin is Narragansett.
Can you repeat the word?
Wampum.
Wampum. W-O-M-P-U-M.
Your word is marzipan. Marzipan.
Can I have a language of origin, please?
Language of origin of marzipan is originally Arabic. And it passed through Italian and into German before becoming English. Marzipan.
Marzipan. M-A-R-Z-I-P-A-N. Marzipan.
Betty, I've got a homonym for you. Your word is demotic. Demotic. And it means of, belonging to, connected with the form of modern Greek that is based on colloquial usage. Everyone in Callista's ancestral village spoke demotic Greek, except the priest who usually spoke a more pedantic form of the language. Demotic.
Demotic.
Yes.
D-E-M-O-T-I-C. Demotic.
Okay, Montel, your word is Bachstein. Bachstein.
May I have the definition, please?
Bachstein is a German cheese resembling Limburger that is produced in a brick shape. Amongst the German cheeses, Bachstein is Helmut's favorite. Bachstein.
Bachstein.
Yes.
B-A-C-K. S-T-E-I-N, Bachstein.
Your word, ma'am? Pneumatic. Pneumatic.
Can I have the language of origin?
Pneumatic is Greek, or is from Greek.
Can I have the definition?
Pneumatic means adapted for holding compressed air or inflated with air. The development of the pneumatic tire was a major advance for the bicycle.
Pneumatic.
Pneumatic.
P-N-E-U-M-A-T-I-C. Pneumatic.
And Blaze, your word? Staccato. Staccato.
It's Italian.
The language of origin?
Yeah.
The language of origin is originally French, but passed through Italian before becoming English. Staccato.
S-T-A-C-C-A-T-O. Staccato.
Your word? Mayonnaise. Mayonnaise.
Mayonnaise. M. A. Y. O. N. N. A. I. S. E. Mayonnaise.
Nash, would you please spell Eureka?
Eureka. Eureka. U. R. E. K. E. A.
Your word is amicable. Amicable.
May I have it in a sentence, please?
The definition of amicable is characterized as if by friendship and goodwill. In a sentence, Carla and Janine have had an amicable relationship since they settled their initial dispute. Amicable.
Amicable. A M I C A B L E. Amicable.
Emily, your word is kosh. Kosh.
May I get a language of origin?
The language of origin is originally Lithuanian, but it is now a Russian word, kosh.
May I get a definition?
Definition, a kosh is a ladle or drinking vessel with a boat-shaped bowl and a handle at one end. The silver kosh made by Fabergé sold for $20,000 at auction. Kosh.
Kosh. K-O-V-S-H.
Ethan, would you spell poltergeist? Poltergeist.
Poltergeist. P-O-L-T-E-R. G-E-I-S-T, poltergeist.
Start the next round. Hildana, your word is yamen. Yamen.
Definition, please.
A yamen is an establishment used by a Chinese government official or department for official business and often as a residence. A typical yamen included a courtyard and a hall, offices, prison cells, storerooms, and residences. Yamen.
Language of origin, please.
Language of origin is Chinese. Yamen. There are no alternate pronunciations. Yamen.
Yamen. Y-A-M-E-N. Yamen.
Okay, your word, altruism. Altruism.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Altruism.
Can I have the definition?
Yes, of course. Altruism is uncalculated consideration of regard for or devotion to others' interests, sometimes in accordance with an ethical principle. Altruism is considered a virtue in many cultures and religions.
Can I have
language of origin? Language of origin is originally Latin, then French.
Can you repeat the word again?
Altruism. Altruism.
Altruism. A-L-T-R-U-I-S-M. Altruism.
Your word is kuruma. Kuruma.
K-U-R-U-N-A.
Lewis, would you please spell amphibious? Amphibious.
Amphibious. May I have a definition?
Amphibious means able to live both on land and in water. Justin named frogs, crocodiles, and beavers as three examples of amphibious creatures. Amphibious.
Are there no alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
Amphibious. A-M-P-H-I-B-I-O-U-S, amphibious.
Your word, Leah, is tuckahoe.
Tuckahoe.
Definition, please.
Tuckahoe is a Virginian, especially a Virginian living east of the Blue Ridge, used as a nickname. A tuckahoe guided visitors around Virginia's oldest plantation, Tuckahoe.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is Algonquin. Tuckahoe.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No, that is the only pronunciation.
Tuckahoe.
T-U-C-K-H-A-O.
Tuckahoe.
Okay, John David, your word is lederhosen.
Lederhosen, may I have a definition, please?
Lederhosen are knee-length leather trousers worn, especially in Bavaria. All the men who volunteered to work at the Oktoberfest were asked to wear lederhosen.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No, there are no alternate pronunciations.
I have a language of origin.
Language of origin is German.
Lederhosen. Lederhosen. L-E-D-E-R-H-O-S-E-N. Lederhosen.
Actually, your word is Borzoi. Borzoi.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is Russian.
Borzoi. B-O-R. Z. O-I. Borzoi.
Your word, Sophie. Cossack. Cossack.
Cossack. May I have the language of origin?
The language of origin is, it is a, the word is from a Turkish-derived Russian word and a Turkish-derived Ukrainian word. Cossack. I'm sorry, it says there is a homonym, and defining this, a member of a favored military caste of Russian frontiersmen and border guards in Tsarist Russia. In a sentence, the museum's hat display included one worn by a Cossack who was an ancestor of the curator, Mr. Kuban. Cossack.
Cossack. C-O-S-S-A-C-K. Cossack.
Your word also is a homonym, or your homonym, femininity. Femininity, the quality or nature of the female gender, womanliness. Mrs. Thompson, who has five sons, longs for more femininity in her home.
Language of origin.
Language of origin is originally Latin, but it went through French before becoming English.
Femininity. F-E-M-I. N-I-N-I-T-Y, femininity.
Your word, Zachary, is Hafez. Excuse me, Hafez. The definition, Hafez, is a Muslim who knows the Quran by heart, used as a title of respect. Hafez Mehmet can quote an appropriate verse from the Quran for every occasion.
Language of origin
is Arabic. Hafiz.
Hafiz. H-A-F-E-Z. Hafiz.
Your word? Ocarina.
Ocarina. May I have the definition?
An ocarina is a simple wind instrument or toy of the flute class, having a mouthpiece and finger holes usually made of terracotta in various sizes. Professor Miller unearthed a four-hole ocarina used by the ancient Maya. Ocarina.
Ocarina. O-C-A-R-I-N-A. Ocarina.
Would you please spell the word Philippic? Philippic.
Prolific. P-H-I-L-I-P-P-I-C.
Your word is rapport. Rapport.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
Language of origin is French.
Can I have definition?
Definition, a relation characterized by harmony, conformity, accord, or affinity. Mr. Rodriguez believes establishing rapport with all of his students will increase their achievement. Rapport.
Rapport. R-A-P-P-O-R-T. Rapport.
Medley, your word is batik.
Batik. B-A-T-I-K. Batik.
Motel, your word is another homonym. Coloratura. Coloratura. It's the florid ornamentation in vocal music, as in runs, trills, riffs, and arpeggios. Barry thinks that he would enjoy opera music more if it did not contain so much coloratura.
Coloratura. C O A O O. R. A T O R A. Coloratura.
And your word, honey, is Alcazar.
Alcazar. Can I have the language of origin?
The language of origin is originally Arabic. The word went into Spanish before being adopted by English.
Can I have the definition?
An Alcazar is a Spanish fortress or palace. Hector had to stop and rest while climbing the steep steps to the Alcazar.
Alcazar. A-L-C-A-Z-A-R. Alcazar.
Your word, please. Surveillance. Surveillance.
S-U-R-V-E-I-L-L-A-N-C-E. Surveillance.
And Vinny, would you please spell alchemy? Alchemy.
Alchemy?
Alchemy.
Are there any other pronunciations?
There are no other pronunciations. Alchemy.
Definition, please.
Alchemy is the medieval chemical science and speculative philosophy whose aims were to transmute base metals into gold. The wizard's apprentice was determined to learn enough alchemy to turn lead into gold. Alchemy.
Alchemy. A L C H E M Y. Alchemy.
Your word is tritium. Tritium.
May I have the language of origin, please?
Tritium is originally a Greek word that passed into Latin. Tritium.
May I have the definition, please?
Tritium is the radioactive isotope of hydrogen that has atoms of three times the mass of ordinary light hydrogen atoms. Because tritium is luminescent, some gun sights are coated with it to allow them to be used at night.
Tritium. T-R-I-T-I-U-M. Tritium.
Emily, your word is coffle. Coffle.
May I get the language of origin?
Coffle is from the Arabic.
May I get a definition?
And a definition, a coffle is a gang of men or train of animals fastened together. A coffle of horses pulled the loaded wagon up the mountain road. Coffle.
Coffle. C-O-F-F-L-E. Coffle.
We'll now begin round 7.
Gildana, your word is a homonym. Your word is tamarind. And tamarind is a fruit of a widely cultivated tropical tree that has seeds that are cooked and also ground into meal. The chef prepared a sauce made with tamarind to serve with the roast duck. Tamarind.
Language of origin.
Language of origin, it's from an Indian geographical name that went into Arabic, then Portuguese and Spanish, then English. Tamarind. Tamarind and tamarind.
Tamarind. T-A-M-A-R-I-N-D.
Okay. Your word is zephyr. Zephyr.
Zephyr, can I have a definition?
Zephyr is a soft, warm breeze from the west. The gentle zephyr was not sufficient to keep Renee's kite airborne. Zephyr.
That is part of speech.
Part of speech, it is a noun.
And the language of origin
is Greek. Zephyr.
Zephyr, are there any pronunciations?
No, there are not.
Zephyr. Z-E-P-H-Y-R. Zephyr.
Eddie, you have got a homonym. Your word is topang. Topang. The word is a Javanese dramatic performance in which the actors wear grotesque masks and act in pantomime. Lily's collection of masks includes a replica of one worn in a topang she attended while on vacation in Java. Topang.
T-O-P-E-N-G.
Okay, Lewis, I'd like you to try Lakshan. Lakshan.
Lakshan.
Lakshan.
May I have a definition?
Lakshan bar is noodles. Natalie loved kugel made with lakshan and ricotta cheese. Lakshan.
Lakshan. L-O-K-S-H-E-N.
John David, symbiosis. Symbiosis.
Symbiosis, can I have the definition, please?
Symbiosis means living together of two dissimilar organisms in any of various mutually beneficial relations. Relationships. Some insects depend on a symbiosis with bacteria to supplement otherwise nutrition-poor diets. Symbiosis.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Symbiosis.
Symbiosis. S-Y-M-B-I-O-S-I-S. Symbiosis.
Your word, Ashley, is corpuscle. Corpuscle.
Corpuscle. C-O-R-P-O-S-S-A-L. Corpuscle.
Zofia, would you please spell tahini?
Tahini. I have the language of origin.
Tahini is from Arabic.
Tahini.
Tahini.
Tahini. T-A-H-I-N-I. Tahini.
And your word, AJ, is ersatz.
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 May I have a definition?
Ersatz means substitute or synthetic. The invention of nylon made ersatz silk stockings available to women of all economic classes. Ersatz.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is German.
Ersatz. E-R-S-A-T-Z.
Okay, your word? Paradigm.
Paradigm. May I have the definition?
Paradigm is an example or a pattern. The paradigm of sin and salvation underlies much of 17th century English poetry.
Paradigm. P-A-R-A-D-I-G-M. Paradigm.
And your word is water zooey.
Water zooey. W-A-T-E-R-Z-O-O-I. Water zooey.
Your word, sachem.
Can I have the language of origin, please?
It is from Narragansett and Pequot.
Can I have the definition?
The definition is the leader of a political party, specifically one of the 12 governors of the Tammany Society. William Tweed was a sachem of the political organization known as Tammany Hall. Sachem.
Let's read this word.
Part of speech.
Could you please repeat the word?
Please repeat the word. Sachem.
Sachem. S-A-C-H-E-M. Sachem.
Mendy, would you please spell Bolshevik? Bolshevik.
Bolshevik. B-O-L-S-H-E-V-I-K. Bolshevik.
Your word, Annie, is M is Novillero. Novillero.
Novillero. Can I have the language of origin?
The language of origin is Spanish.
Can I have the definition?
The definition, a Novillero is an aspiring bullfighter who has not yet attained the rank of matador. All summer, the Novillero practiced in the pasture with young bulls. Novillero.
Novillero. N-O-V-I-L-L-E-R-O.
Your word, Blaze, is Fräulein. Fräulein.
Fräulein. F-R-A-U-L-E-I-N. Fräulein.
Would you please spell Blase? Blase.
Blase. B L A S E. Blase.
Facetious. Facetious.
May I have the language of origin?
Facetious comes from the French, which formed it from a Latin word. Facetious.
May I have the definition, please?
Definition of facetious means characterized by pleasantry or levity. Pleasantry or levity. Stimulating laughter. When the radio show host asked the pop star about his motorcycle accident, the interviewee dodged the question with a facetious comment.
Facetious. F-A-C-E-T-I-O-U-S. Facetious.
Emily, your word is Dahlia. Dahlia.
May I have the language of origin?
Your language of origin is Latin. The word is from a Latin word and from a Swedish name. Dahlia.
Can I get a definition?
The Dahlia is a plant of the genus of tuberous rooted herbs having rayed flower heads. The brightly colored flowers of the Dahlia are often very large.
Dahlia, D-A-H.
L-I-A, Dahlia.
Your word, Ethan, is kibe. Kibe.
Kibe. K-I-B-E-I, kibe.
Debaris. Debaris means to relieve, especially by removing what impedes or encumbers. Assigned to greet the guests, Jake will debaris them of their coats immediately after he welcomes them. Debaris.
Language of origin.
Language of origin. This is a word that went from Portuguese to Spanish to French. Debaris. An alternate pronunciation is debaris. Debaris or debaris.
Debaris. D. E-B-E-R-U-S-S, the bears.
Your word is strediot. Strediot.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations, no. Strediot.
Strediot?
Strediot.
Stradiot?
Stradiot.
Stradiot. Can I have the definition?
The definition of stradiot is a light cavalryman recruited especially from Albania, Dalmatia, or Greece and employed in the Venetian armies in the 15th and 16th centuries. The prize of the History's Museum's collection is the ornamented saddle of an Albanian stradiot.
Can you put it in sentence?
Pardon me?
Can you put it in sentence?
The prize of the History Museum's collection is the ornamented saddle of an Albanian stradiot.
Can I have the part of speech?
Part of speech is an noun.
Can I have the language of origin?
The language of origin is, it comes from a word that went from Greek to Italian to French. Stradiot.
Stradiot. S-T-R-A-D-I-E-T-T-E.
Now your word, Addy, is Orpington. Orpington.
We have the definition of the word.
An Orpington is an English breed of large, deep-chested, broad-backed domestic fowls with short, unfeathered legs. And in a sentence, the Orpington was bred to have both good meat quality and to lay eggs. Orpington.
O-R-P-I-N-G-T-O-N.
Okay, Lewis, you have a homonym. The word is frieze. This frieze is a sculptured or richly ornamented band is on a building or a piece of furniture. The detail of the architrave's frieze could be appreciated only upon close inspection. Frieze.
And language of origin?
Language of origin is originally Greek, a geographical name that passed into Latin, then French. Freeze.
Can you give me a definition again?
The definition, again, is a sculptured or richly ornamented band as on a building or a piece of furniture. Conjunctive and yours is also a homonym. Your word is pilus. This pilus is the hair or a hair or a structure resembling a hair. The forensic scientist, science technician used tweezers to remove a pilus from the jacket he found at the crime scene.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations.
May I have the language of origin?
Language of origin is Latin. Pilus.
Pilus. P-I-L-A-C-E. Pilus.
Sophie, would you please spell Bandalore? Bandalore.
I have the definition, please.
The definition of Bandalore is a toy with an automatically winding cord by which it is brought back to the hand when thrown. Jeffrey Watt brought a Bandalore to school for show and tell. Bandalore.
I have the language of origin.
Language of origin is unknown.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
No, there are no alternate pronunciations. Bandalore.
Bandalore. B-A-N-D-A-L-O-R. Bandalore.
Okay, AJ. Decahedral. Decahedral.
Decahedral, may I have a definition?
Yes, decahedral of or relating to a figure or solid formed by 10 faces. The Board of Trustees decided on a decahedral design for the new museum. Decahedral.
May I have language of origin?
The word is made up of two parts that went from Greek to Latin, plus an English combining. Decahedral.
Decahedral. D-E-C-A-H-E-D-R-A-L.
Decahedral. You have a word. Chalybinite. Chalybinite.
May I have the definition?
Gelignite is a gelatin dynamite in which the adsorbent base is largely potassium nitrate or a similar nitrate, usually with some wood pulp. Gelignite was used to blast a passage through the rocks for a roadway. Gelignite.
Gelignite. G-E-L-I-G-N-I-T-E. Gelignite.
Your word now is Cotswold. Cotswold.
Cotswold. May I have a definition?
Yeah. Let me give you another pronunciation. Cotswold or Cotswold. In the definition, it's a sheep of an English breed of long-wooled sheep. The Cotswold breed of sheep originated in the hills of the same name in the south of England.
Have the origin of the word?
It comes from a British geographical name, Cotswold.
Cotswold.
C-O-T-T-S-W-A-L-D. Cotswold.
Okay, your word. Proprioceptive. Proprioceptive.
Can I have definition, please?
Proprioceptive means activated by, relating to, or being stimuli produced within the organism. Daniel's study tested whether blindfolded subjects could use proprioceptive feedback to move one arm a prescribed distance. Proprioceptive.
Can I have a language of origin?
Language of origin, it comes from two different Latin elements.
Can you please repeat the word?
Proprioceptive.
Proprioceptive. P-R-O. P-R-E-O-C-E-P-T-I-V-E.
I think your word, neurological. Neurological.
Neurological. N-E-U-R-O-L-O-G-I-C-A-L. Neurological.
And your word is Damson. Damson.
Damson. Can I have the definition?
Damson is the fruit of a rather small, compact plum that has dark purple fruit and is native to Asia Minor. Becky added some damson to her fruit salad for a little exotic flair. Damson.
Can I have a language of origin?
Language of origin is a Syrian geographical name that went through Latin to English.
Damson, D-A-M-S-E-N, Damson.
Okay, please, would you please spell mafioso?
What's the definition?
Mafioso is a member of a secret organization composed chiefly of criminal elements and usually held to controlling racketeering. The famous actor, using this in a sentence, the famous actor is playing a 1920s mafioso in his latest film.
Mafioso. M-A-F-I-O-S-O. Mafioso.
Your word, gratis. Gratis.
Gratis. Definition?
Gratis means without charge or recompense, free. Some restaurants no longer provide water gratis.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is Latin. Gratis.
Part of speech.
Part of speech, it is an adverb.
G R O T T I S. Gratis.
And you have a homonym. Your word is Yeggman. Yeggman. And Yeggman is a safecracker or a robber. Everyone was relieved when the police managed quickly to capture the Yeggman who had robbed the bank.
May I have the language of origin, please?
No, you may. I'm sorry. The language of origin is unknown. Yeggman.
Yeggman. Why? A G E M A N, Yeggman.
Would you please spell Hornblend? Hornblend.
May I get a language of origin?
Language of origin is German.
Can I get a definition?
And the definition is Hornblend is a material, a mineral consisting of common black, dark green, or brown variety of aluminous amphibole containing considerable iron. Hornblende is often found as dark flecks in granite. Hornblende.
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 H-O-R-N-B-L-E-N-D-E. Hornblende.
Would you please spell semaphore? Semaphore.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations. Semaphore.
C-I-M-O-P-H-O-R, semaphore.
extra is a jump forward in fencing followed by a lunge. Dora watched a video online showing how properly to perform the balestra and other advanced fencing footwork maneuvers.
Country of origin?
The language of origin, this word came from the Latin and went to Italian. Balestra.
Balestra. B-A-L-L-E-S-T-R-A.
Okay, AJ, would you please spell pomiform? Pomiform.
Can you repeat the word?
Pomiform. Pomiform.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is it was originally made of Latin parts. Pomiform.
Pomiform, may I have a definition?
Definition means shaped like an apple. Kayla's favorite piece in the museum is a Renaissance painting depicting the three graces holding golden pomiform orbs. Pomiform.
Pomiform. Can you repeat the word?
Yes. Pomiform.
Pomiform. P O M I F O R M. Pomiform.
Okay, Jackson, your word is Carthaginian. Carthaginian.
May I have the definition?
A Carthaginian means of, relating to, or characteristic of Carthage, the ancient city of North Africa that is now a suburb of Tunis, Tunisia. The Carthaginian landscape features sea inlets both to the north and to the south. Carthaginian.
May I have the language of origin?
The word is made up of the name of the ancient city in North Africa plus an English combining form, Carthaginian.
Carthaginian, C-A-R-T-H-A-G-I-N-I-A-N.
Bentley, your word is hallucinogen. Hallucinogen.
Hallucinogen, H-A-L-L-U. C-I-N-A-T-I-O-N.
Place your word, tintinabulary. Tintinabulary.
Definition.
Tintinabulary means of, relating to, or characterized by bells and their sound. The bell ringers gave a tintinabulary rendition of Winter Wonderland. Tintinabulary.
Can you say it again?
Repeat the word.
Yes, sir.
Tintinabulary.
T-I-N-T-I-N. A-B-U-L-A-R-Y. Tintinabulary.
Your word, dianthus. Dianthus.
Can I get a language of origin?
The word consists of two originally Greek parts, dianthus.
Can I get a definition?
And the definition means it is a very large and horticulturally important old world genus of herbs, including pinks and carnations. Ahmad chose several varieties of dianthus, including carnations and sweet william, to plant in his garden. Dianthus.
Dianthus. D I A N T H U Dianthus.
Is rubescent. Rubescent.
Rubescent. May I have language of origin?
Language of origin is Latin. Rubescent.
May I have a definition?
The definition means growing or becoming red. Reddening, flushing. Gloria's rubescent cheeks made her embarrassment obvious. Rubescent.
Rubescent. Can you repeat the word?
I could repeat the word. It is rubescent.
Rubescent.
That's good.
R-U-B-E-S-C-E-N-T. Rubescent.
Your word, cure.
Cure?
Cure.
May I have the definition?
Cure is a drink made of dry white wine and creme de cassis. Emily always orders a cure at her favorite Parisian brasserie. Cure.
May I have the language of origin?
Language of origin, it comes from the name of a French clergyman and politician. Cure.
Can you use it in a sentence?
Emily always orders a cure at her favorite Parisian brasserie.
Are there any other pronunciations?
No, there are no alternate pronunciations. Cure.
Cure. K-E-E-R. Cure.
Would you stay on stage, please? Second row. Your word, Emily. Nene.
May I get a language of origin?
This comes from the Hawaiian. Nene.
May I get a definition?
Nene is a nearly extinct goose of the Hawaiian Islands that inhabits waterless uplands and feeds on berries and vegetation. The toes of the nene, the state bird of Hawaii, are longer than those of other geese and probably an adaptation for climbing on rocky lava flows. Nene.
N-A-E-N-A-E.
Agent, would you try another word, please? Your word is cichlid. Cichlid.
Cichlid. Can you repeat the word?
Cichlid.
Language of origin?
Language of origin consists of a Greek part plus a Latin combining form.
May I have a definition?
The definition is any of a family of chiefly tropical freshwater fish similar to American sunfishes. The fire moth is a popular aquarium cichlid.
Cichlid. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There are no alternate pronunciations. Cichlid is the only one.
Cichlid. S-I-C-L-I-D. Cichlid.
So we will go back. Please resume your original, AJ, your original seat. Realgar. Realgar.
Realgar. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Realgar. Realgar or Realgar?
May I have a definition?
Realgar or Realgar is an orange-red mineral that consists of arsenic sulfide. Realgar is often used to create white fireworks.
Realgar.
Rialgar.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is, it's originally Arabic, but it passed through Catalan and Latin before entering English.
Rialgar. R-E-A-L-G-A-R. Rialgar.
Your word, Jackson, is octopus. Octopus.
May I have the definition?
Yes. Octopus means having 8 feet, limbs, or arms.
Are there any other pronunciations?
No. Octopus is the pronunciation.
May I have the part of speech?
It is an adjective. Let's try the standard pronunciation. Octopus. Octopus. And it still means having 8 feet, limbs, or arms. And it still consists of a Greek part plus an English combining form. Octopus.
Octopus. O-C-T-O-P-U-T-O-U-S.
Your word is neoterism.
Neoterism. Can I get a language of origin?
It's from the Greek.
Can I get a definition?
A definition, it means a newly invented word or phrase. Self-aid is a neoterism recently added to some dictionaries. Neoterism.
Neoterism. N-E-O... T-E-R-R-I-S-M.
Hey, Jay, would you try? Hey, Jay, I'd like you to spell the word Tammany. Tammany.
Tammany. Can you repeat the word?
Tammany.
Tammany?
Tammany.
Language of origin?
Language of origin, it's from Delaware, it's from a Delaware Native American name that was altered into the name of an historical American political organization.
Tammany.
Tammany.
Language of origin?
That was the language of origin from the Delaware Native American name.
Can you repeat the word?
Tammany.
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 T-A-M-A-N-Y. Tammany.
Let's go back to the... Your word now, AJ, is cabotage. Cabotage.
Cabotage. Language of origin.
Language of origin. This is a word that went from Latin, probably to Spanish, and then French, plus a French combining form.
Cabotage.
Cabotage.
Definition?
It's trade in or transport in coastal waters or between two points within a country, especially other than by domestic carriers. United States law does not allow cabotage by foreign airlines.
Cabotage. C-A-B-A-T-A-G-E. Cabotage.
Your word, Jackson, is symplectic. Symplectic.
May I have the definition?
Definition of symplectic is relating to or being an intergrowth of two different minerals. The mineral myrmecite is formed from symplectic intergrowth of plagioclase and vermicular quartz. Symplectic.
May I have the language of origin?
It is from the Greek.
Sim. What?
Symplectic.
S-Y-M-P-L-E-C-T-I-C. Symplectic.
Emily, would you please spell theriolatry? Theriolatry.
Theriolatry. May I get a language of origin?
The language of origin, it comes from two originally Greek elements.
May I get a definition?
The definition of theriology is worship of animals or divinities having an animal form. The ancient Egyptians practiced theriolatry, worshiping deities such as Apis, a bull. Theriolatry.
Theriolatry. T H E R I O L T R Y. Theriolatry.
Okay, Jackson. Would you please spell Mediterranean? Mediterranean.
May I have the definition?
Mediterranean means of or relating to the peoples or lands around the sea between Europe and Africa. The country has been exploring for oil and gas off its Mediterranean coast.
Mediterranean. M-E-D-I-T-E-R-R-A-N-E-A. And Mediterranean.
Congratulations. Your word is Pasquinade. Pasquinade.
Pasquinade. We have language order.
Yes, this word, this comes from a word that went from an Italian name into French. Pasquinade.
May I have a definition?
Yes, a pasquinade is a lampoon or satire, usually having political significance. The president's misadventure quickly became the subject of an editorial pasquinade.
Pasquinade. P-A-S-Q-U-E-N-A-D-E.
This is a possible homonym. Your word is forzata. And it is a word, forzato means accented, used as a direction in music to indicate that a single tone or chord is to be sounded more loudly than the rest of a passage. The violins played a quick forzato note before the woodwinds came in. Forzato.
May I get a language of origin?
Language of origin is Italian.
Could you repeat the word?
Forzato.
Forzato. F O R T S A T T O. Forzato.
Your word age 8 is agama.
Agama. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Excuse me. Yes. The word, the first pronunciation, I'm sorry, is agama. The alternate pronunciation is agama.
Language of origin?
Language of origin is Latin.
Definition?
It's a lizard. A lizard of a genus of all terrestrial lizards, many of whom have bright and changeable colors. Depending on the species, the male agama can be brightly colored as in shades such as red, orange, and blue.
Agama. A-G-A-M-A, agama.
Your word is naproxen. Naproxen.
Naproxen. May I get a language of origin?
It consists of an element that went from uranium to Greek to Latin, plus Greek-derived elements.
May I get a definition?
The definition, it's an anti-inflammatory, analgesic, antipyretic drug that is used to treat arthritis. The doctor prescribed naproxen for Mr. Chatterjee's sore shoulder. Naproxen.
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 Naproxen. Naproxen. N-E-P-R-O-X-I-N.